Welcome to RSS DI TV 2020. I am Dr. Sanjay Kamle, and on behalf of VOCAD RSS DI 2020, I welcome you all. I am glad to have with us today a renowned endocrinologist from Ahmedabad, Dr. Om J. Lakhani. Dr. Lakhani, sir, is a consultant endocrinologist working at Zaidat Hospital in Ahmedabad. And, sir, based on your recent talks in RSS DI 2020, we would like to know, after the advent of DPP-4 inhibitors and SGLT2 inhibitors, triple and quadruple therapies have shown promise, and newer studies have shown non-inferiority of the various combinations with comparison to insulin therapies for management of HbA1c and end organ damage. So, how do you weigh quadruple therapy versus early insulin therapy?
Thank you for that question. I think, in India, one of the major challenges is that, unfortunately, for something which is known as psychological insulin resistance, we tend to initiate insulin too late in patients with type 2 diabetes. Though, of course, we have newer and better oral antidiabetics now available in our market, and which tend to have more of some other pleiotropic benefits as well. At end of the day, most of the patients who come to us with type 2 diabetes, they already come with pre-microvascular complications, or they already come too late with a very high HbA1c. At that point of time, I think, adding a fourth drug to a patient who's already failed three oral antidiabetic is not really going to add too much to the overall glycemic management. It is fair if the patient had a reasonable glycemic control and the HbA1c was 7.6, 7.8. But maybe adding a fourth drug would lead to an HbA1c reduction to less than 7. However, the patients who come to us typically tend to have an HbA1c of 8 or 9. In fact, our own data, we have seen that the patients who came to me in the last 3 years, our own analysis shows that an average HbA1c was 9.5, which is quite high. So when the patient comes to us, they are really way behind, how the glycemic control should be. They already have microvascular complications. And I think at that point of time, adding a fourth oral antidiabetic drug would basically not help these patients. I think these patients should be initiated on insulin as early as possible. I think the barrier really lies with our own thinking, and I think that is what is restrictive in this manner.
Thank you, sir. So is insulin initiated too late in Indian diabetic patients?
Yeah, it is. Though we talk a lot about insulin in our own various talks that we give, we talk a lot about in our own guidelines. If you see the RSSTI and the Endocrine Society of India guidelines, they're very clear on when the insulin should be initiated. I think there is no guideline in the world, in fact, to say, including the Indian guidelines, who say that you should add a fourth drug when three drugs have already failed, or to add an oral antidiabetic when your HbA1c is in the range of 9 and 10, when insulin clearly could be beneficial at that situation. So I think guidelines are very clear. However, if you see from the data which has emerged from various studies, overall globally also it's not that great. The average period of time when an insulin is initiated, a basal insulin is initiated, is typically 8.7 or 9 HbA1c. In India, that figure is 10 to 10.5. So our average, in our own study, in our own data set, our average HbA1c is 10.2 when we initiated insulin. So though we do talk a lot about early insulin initiation, in practice, we tend to really lag behind. And I think this psychology has to change.
Sir, so what is the rationale of early insulin use versus quadruple therapy?
I think, a lot of physicians and diabetologists and endocrinologists who are listening to this, I think there's one important thing they have to understand. They have to understand that type 2 diabetes, at end of the day, is still a disease of insulin deficiency vis-a-vis insulin resistance, right? So if you look at this fence, for example, if this is insulin resistance and this is insulin deficiency, early on you have tend to have a very high insulin resistance, whereas the insulin deficiency is relatively static. But by the time you are diagnosed to have type 2 diabetes, your insulin resistance is very high and your insulin production is also pretty low. And you almost have 60% of beta cells which are depleted by this period of time. That is right at the diagnosis when your HbA1c is 6.5, 6.6. Imagine what happens when your HbA1c is in the range of 9 and 10. At this point of time, you almost have a complete depletion of beta cell. Even though adding an oral antidiabetic does help to an extent that it pushes the beta cell, like in case of sulfonylurea, or as a different mechanism, like in case of an SGLT2, at end of the day, they are bound to fail. And we tend to kind of have a thinking of treatment to fail instead of treatment to overcome the complications. So I think at end of the day, I'm not saying early insulin initiation. I think it's I would say timely insulin initiation And depending on the patient's profile and depending on how the patient presents to you, I think a timely insulin initiation would actually protect the beta cell that has been shown in various studies and then prevent the complications from developing over a long period of time. It has been shown by a lot of these legacy studies done for big trials like UK PDS, etc. It has shown that early good glycemic control tends to prevent microvascular complications and macrovascular complications for a long period of time. So I think the biggest rationale I would say is that insulin is the most effective form of treatment for diabetes. And I think early aggressive treatment will prevent long-term complications and prevent, would have a kind of economic advantage also, because the prevention of the complications would really save money and time for the patient as well.
Thank you so much, sir, for sharing your views, and stay tuned to RSSDI TV 2020 for more recent updates from RSSDI 2020. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dr. Sanjay. Thank you.